Hello, ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to Exotic Astrology, and I'm delighted again to have Anuradha Ji with us again. Welcome, madam, to Exotic Astrology, and today she's going to share one attribute about all the seven planets that we have, and she has also given ages for the planets, and I was amazed to see the presentation, and there are colors for every planet, the colors which the planets like, of course. So welcome, and please share the presentation, and the stage is yours.
Thank you, Bhavaji. It's fun to be back on your channel again. And today I'm going to talk about one of the basic fundamental principles of each of the planets. See, each of the planets have so many attributes. Okay, so we get lost as to what each planet tells us about. Now, each planet is vibrating on a particular frequency, colors that we associate each planet with. And each planet in the chart is trying to exert a certain influence of its own on us. Okay? So what is every planet trying to tell us? That is a major thing that I'm going to cover here. And every planet will also have a certain year when it becomes extremely right, should I say, or should I say when it becomes strong enough to vibrate at that level, and then it will show its maximum vibration at that period, at that point of time. Okay, so that is the second layer, and then we have so many layers to it. But to begin with, the first thing is when you're seeing a chart, what do you see? Okay, so now, you were planning to ask me a question, Bhavajit, which was...
I was planning to ask you, why is it 7, why not 9?
Yes. So, Rahu and Ketu are supposed to be... people have a lot of... people have a lot of fallacy about Rahu and Ketu. They think that Rahu and Ketu are very, very malefic planets. To begin with, I will first talk a few minutes on those two planets, Rahu and Ketu. Rahu is a planet, Ketu is a planet which is about the inlet of karma. They're called karmic control planets by M.C. Jain, a very beautiful title given to them, karmic control planets, because they, one of them, Ketu, is our inlet of karma, okay, and Rahu is our outlet of karma. What do you mean by inlet of karma and outlet of karma? So through a certain point where Ketu is sitting in your chart, you will see that karmic things coming up your way. Okay, or your past trying to catch up with you. And how you work on that past life, I'm not saying, as of tomorrow, I'm saying past life. How you work on that past life will be defined by this Rahu. So Rahu and Ketu have very definite roles in the chart. That is very well defined. And all of us, most of us are very afraid of Rahu and Ketu. Why so? Because we do not trust what we have done in our past life. So that is that is why every transit of Rahu and Ketu, you have people, so many people like getting afraid. Is it going to be bad? And with Adra, people are heightened about Rahu Ketu transit. But now with the seven planets and their attributes. So the first one that we're going to take up is Sun. Sun is also your soul. Okay. So every human being on this planet, every human being, will keep it simple, it takes birth due to certain reasons and with a certain purpose. So you come to this planet with a certain purpose. And that is the reason, or that is the region that you, where you want to work or where you want to shine in. Okay? To shine in a particular zone. Okay? So, let me take this chart of Rajesh Khanna. Rajesh Khanna was the first superstar in India. There have been many stars who have been very well known before Rajesh Khanna, but when you had to coin the term superstar, it was coined after Rajesh Khanna. Dilip Kumar was one of the very, very bright stars in the film industry, in Bollywood film industry in India. But Rajesh Khanna was the one who, for whom the word superstar was coined. Okay, and when you look at his chart, Sun is sitting in the fourth house. Where is Sun sitting? Fourth house. What is fourth house about? It is about masses. It is with the 10th Lord Mercury, again profession, and it is with Venus. Venus and Mercury, we know, are the planets associated with acting, with fine arts, and adulation, the kind of love and affection people have for you. Sitting in the fourth house, Venus is very strong again over here. So this fourth house Venus helps him to move up in life. Okay, and so he shines in that zone, and he shines and he amongst the masses. Okay, he's creating a place for himself in the masses. Okay, then we take up the chart of, then we take up Moon. Moon is one of the most changeable elements, because you see, in one whole month, Moon changes its shape and size. From one Purnima to another Purnima, it has gone a full circle of losing its shape, losing its shine, and then coming back to getting back its shape and shine. So Moon is the planet that will, and it's one of those about emotions also, and Moon is associated with your past life tendencies. So the tendencies that you tend to bring into this life, your habits, your reactive impulses, is associated with Moon. So Moon is all about change and mobility. Okay, so here I take the example of, you know, people will find it very, very difficult when they associate a person like Arnold Schwarzenegger with a feminine color like pink and Moon, you know. But you have to understand that this man went through phenomenal changes in his life, coming from an ordinary family in Austria and going through a lot of hardship and becoming Mr. World, Mr. Universe for 7 consecutive years, getting your pictures of your body plastered all over the billboards in the world and everything. That's a phenomenal task, if you ask me, isn't it? That's a great, great thing. So the changes that, yes,
humble beginnings,
very humble beginnings, and then he went on to become the governor of a state in the US. So, you know, it's like the new moon to the moon of the full moon. So you can see the changes that have happened to him over the period of time. So that is why, and you see Moon is sitting in the 7th house of career. It's the second lord of wealth. It is the second lord of your education. It's the second lord of your ethics, morality, determination. Okay. And it's sitting in the 7th house. It's sitting in, if I wouldn't be putting in nakshatras here, because it would be taking it to a different level. But then, you know, I want to keep it simple. So you see how we can just say that, yes, you can plot a change. I could do it with all the same planets in one chart, but I'm taking each chart differently because I want to show that you can plot it like that. Now, when we come to Mars, Mars is all about energy. So wherever you put your energy, okay, this is a place where you can put a lot of your energy in. And Marilyn Monroe, okay? So for Marilyn Monroe, Mars is the lord of the 5th house of celebrityhood, right? And the 5th house of being known, it's a throne. It's the throne that a person, not the throne, it's actually the crown that person wears. Let's not forget that the fifth house of the natural zodiac is Leo, the king of the jungle. Okay, and 10th house is related to your profession. It's related to your work. So Marilyn Monroe, again, she didn't have a happy beginning at all. She didn't have any happy beginning in life. She had a very, very upsetting, a very, very tumultuous childhood. But when she grew up, okay, her most important factor in life was, I have to be the person in my career and I have to be well known. I cannot die as an unknown person. And she was constantly updating. She put in a lot of energy in transforming herself from a very tied down brunette to the blonde she was known for, dumb blonde. The dumb blonde, she had an image. People say she actually created that persona of hers, that dumb blonde image of hers. But she was a very, very sharp lady. She was a very intelligent lady. So she put her passion in changing herself so that she was the best in her career at that time. And she was in constant battle with others who did not take her seriously. Okay. Now we come to Mercury. Mercury is all about the art of presentation. Mercury is all about communication. Mercury is all about how people know you for what you are. You know, how when you open your mouth, you should be having somebody listening to you. So this is what, you know, what Atal Bihari Vajpayee ji, who was the only minister in, only prime minister to have, in those days, today we do have the Bharatiya Janata Party as a party ruling the country. But in the times when there was nobody around except for the Congress, he was the one person who, with the help of a few of his friends, RSS, that is Rashtriya Seva Sangh, had its own ideology. Okay. But that ideology was very much put forward, and you know, he formed the BJP, he worked as a founding member, he was the one who set in a lot of stones, the building blocks for the BJP, for what we see it now today. And in fact, he was one of those people who was noticed. You see, when there's a sea of crowd there, a few people are noticed. And he was one of few people who were noticed, even by Jawaharlal Nehru, who said that he is going to become a prime minister one day because of the country one day, because he had great communication skills. Atal Bihari Vajpayee ji was a great writer. He was a great writer. You know, his poems were beautiful. So, Mercury plays a very important role in his chart. And this Mercury is the lord of the ninth house, of an orator, of a teacher, of a person who can impress upon others. This is a retrograde Mercury, the Mercury that does not speak without thinking twice. The Mercury, which under pressure will give one of the best results. He was the one who built up the BJP. The building block of BJP were laid by him. He set the foundation stones on the RSS ideology. And Mercury is the lord of the 12th house of international fame. So he did a great job, if you ask me. Now we move on to Jupiter. First grandmaster of India, where we are talking about his skills as a chess player in a very, very Russian dominated field. Okay, he was the first person to crack through that shield and became a grandmaster for a huge period of time, Vishwanathan Anand. And wherever Jupiter sits, it's one of the attributes of Jupiter. Jupiter is the guru. He wants, guru means heavy. So, and Jupiter is a gaseous planet. Okay, so Jupiter is expansive in nature. When we're talking about the elements, Jupiter is ether. And we know that ether expands. So wherever Jupiter is sitting in your chart, it brings in good fortune for you and it brings in expansion for you. In Dr. B.V. Raman's chart, the father of modern astrology in India, okay, so he's the one responsible for spreading astrology the world over. Jupiter is sitting in the 10th house. Again, expansion. He's Aquarius Lagna, Jupiter is sitting in Scorpio. In this chart, again, we see Jupiter is sitting in the 10th house and he is Capricorn Lagna. So you see, his work, his good fortunes expanded in his work. All of you can check it, these points that I'm talking about, all of you can check in your charts. So now Venus is all about pleasures of life. So we have the first person that we have here is A.R. Rahman, about pleasures of life. Where does Venus in his chart sit? Venus is the 6th lord of competition, the 11th lord of games. A.R. Rahman is one of those people from India who have made it big, larger than life in the music world abroad. He works with who's who of India. Now, not just who's who of India, but who's who of world musician. There's not a corner in the surround world. There's not any place on this planet where he has not gone and performed with the truth. So, and he's got recognition. 11th house is recognition, honor. He's got that all. Another example that I couldn't help adding on is Frank Sinatra. Again, humble beginnings, very humble beginnings. But then the skinny boy, very, very thin boy, made it to the Hollywood with all his jokes, with everything, and his director. He was known as the ace entertainer of his times. That is sitting in the 3rd house of oratorship, again, of being, of creativity. 3rd house of creativity. Again, Venus being a planet of creativity, and 3rd house is also your publishing, 3rd house is directing, all these things, creative attributes will come from the 3rd house. And he made his mark in that place. Okay. And it's also his Lagna Lord. So everything would reflect back to him, nowhere else. So Saturn is karma. Luggage, need of discipline, area of responsibility and skill development. So this is the chart where you do need to put in your skills. You need to develop your skills. Okay. And see, if I'm talking about John F. Kennedy, a very well-known figure. Okay. A person who's known worldwide. So I don't really need to go into a lot of description. He became a senator. He became responsible for making decisions for a country. A lot of decisions he had to take, which had to be very correct, otherwise they could harm the country. And Saturn again is the lord of the 5th house, celebrityhood. Looking into the 5th house, it's a lot of the 6th house of competitiveness. You don't become a senator, or you don't become a president without going through a lot of competitions. So here he needed to discipline himself. That is his area. Okay. And Saturn is also sitting in the 11th house of your contacts. So, and your responsibilities, yes, your gains. So yes, he had to be very careful about the kind of people he met. He should have been very careful about the kind of alliances he made, all these things. Skill development in those areas also. So let's move forward. Now, most of us, if you're looking into this chart, we would be unhappy. We would say that, okay, so I know all these things, but let me ask, how would it reflect for me? See, the year is 22 years. So when talking about these, why did I put in a certain year? Okay, first of all, you can get these years as the years of maturity years of a planet. So at a specific year, a planet will start to mature. Okay, and how do you see? So at that specific year, there must be something related to the houses that this planet is owning. Houses or house as in the case of sun and moon, or it could also be the place this planet is sitting in, the house this planet is sitting in. So at that juncture, something must have happened.
And you mentioned you found these years in a specific book.
No, there are many books that will give you, or this, the classics will give you. But if you want a short method, which is a very particular nice book, which you know all of us should go through for our elementary reading, that is Gopesh Kumar Oja ji's Predictive Astrology for the Hindus.
Okay.
So they come from a generations of royal priests, okay, and wherein it was astrology was knowing astrology was a given. So you had to learn it, okay? You didn't have an option. So when he's given a lot many other ages also, and that I'll take it up. So the first thing, and these ages are given in many other books. You should also read Faldipika by the translation of Faldipika by Gopesh Kumar Oja ji. It's a very beautiful book again. So
thank you for the information.
You're most welcome. It is available both in Hindi and English. Okay. So,
another question I want to ask you here. So, when you say sun becomes active at 22, so in astrology, like the first year is the year when the baby is born. Okay. So, when you say 22, does it mean
that the sun matures at the age of 22? I'm not saying it becomes active.
Okay.
Every planet is active all the time. Okay, you're eating, you're drinking, you're going to the washroom. You're studying, you're playing. So planets are active, but they mature. So some event which is very very prominent apart from, and these are not just one single years. Okay, there is a cycle of these years that will follow.
Yeah. So regarding that, there's a technical question which many people ask in this area. That so suppose somebody is born in the year 2000, maybe you know February 5th. Okay, so then by the time he is 2021, his 21 years will be complete.
Yes,
and then his 22nd year begins.
Yeah,
is it that year or is it from February 2022 when his 22 years completely?
So his 22 years is over, so when we start counting from the birth year. So 2000 to 2001 is the first year. 2002, 2003, 2004, 2005, 2006, 2007, 2008, 2009, 2010. Yeah, 2020 is his 20th year is over. 21, 21st year is over. And then that year, the sun wherever is sitting will become very active. So see, an incident, any event which is supposed to leave its mark for a long period cannot happen just on my birthday. I wake up next day morning, some event, very very strong event has happened in my life. Doesn't happen like that. It is a culmination, right? So like I will just give you an example, Bhabji. See, I am planting a tree. Okay, so the tree will it is not going to happen that tomorrow morning, today I planted a tree in my garden. Tomorrow morning, I'm not going to wake up and find a sugarcane plant out of it. I'm not. In fact, for the next 5 days, I'm not going to see anything. Then probably a small root and a small shoot. Typically, after, say, 10, 20 days, I'll see a little small three leaves, four leaves coming out. In a year's time, I might see a hedge. Okay, and then the plant grows 3 years, 4 years. Now it's a different time. So I find a small bud of fruit coming out. So this fruit is not born yesterday. It's not like, again, I overnight, tomorrow morning, I open my eyes, I see a pomegranate or see a banana or a bunch of bananas or a papaya or something like that. It's not going to happen overnight. That event will start its course by the time 15 days, 20 days, I will see a ripe fruit.
Okay. And now another question many people will ask is, of course, that's not required, but just if somebody asks, so when you say year, so this will mean from specifically in that month, in the Tithi Pravesh time, right?
See, Tithi Pravesh, you're taking it on a different level. I will keep...
No, I just wanted, just as a technical date, because some people may say, when is the birthday? Because that necessarily...
From that birthday, let's take a solar return instead of Tithi Pravesh. Let's take or you can also take it in the Tithi Pravesh chart, but
either way, that solar month you can take,
yes,
that solar,
so it will month. Be just the 5, 7, 10 days here and there, but okay. That solar month, say, so if your birthday falls on 25th of May, okay, then when the 22nd year is starting on 25th of May, so that is the year. Well, then you have the plant, the sun will already start showing its, it has accumulated certain amount of energy. Now it's time to for its energy to start blooming and showing it to its to others.
Okay. And one more question. Have you seen the nakshatras also playing out the role? Suppose as you showed in somebody's case, you know, Vishwanathan Ananda, I guess, Jupiter in the 10th. Was it his chart?
Yeah. See, you know that I am in love with the nakshatras and the panchang. You know that for a fact. Nakshatras will definitely be adding on. In this class, I didn't want to work on the nakshatras particularly because I wanted to do something very different from the nakshatras. But when you bring in nakshatras, they will add on to the flavor of how the event will unfold.
Okay.
So depending on which nakshatra it is sitting, it will tell you the kind of event that it will unfold.
Okay, and another question.
Unfold.
Okay. And another question many people might ask that, suppose my somebody's Venus is sitting, or not Venus, I would say, suppose Jupiter is sitting somewhere, and Saturn is also sitting there. They are conjunct. Okay.
Yeah.
So now, does it happen that when Jupiter, because Jupiter gets activated quite earlier than Saturn, so does it happen?
The support of Saturn. It will get that support of Saturn. Why just sitting? Why just sitting? So this was your question. So what will Saturn do, right?
My question was that does it happen that when Jupiter gets active, Saturn also gets active, or Jupiter will not be
until
36, like Saturn.
Saturn is supporting you all the way.
Okay.
So what happens is, I'll show you the chart. Very good question that you asked. I'll show you the chart. Okay. So, now, Mars. Okay. So when we're talking about Mars, I jumped the gun for you on this question. When we're talking about Mars, we're talking about Marilyn Monroe. So Marilyn Monroe's chart, Jupiter and Mars are sitting together.
Oh, okay.
Now,